Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to Nspired Yoga at Home. I hope you enjoyed your Monday class yesterday. And as I said in the newsletter, I will be recording a class that will be available every Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday morning. So you have three new classes from me each and every week. And let me know how you're doing with the classes and if there's anything special that you need from me. Always email, text, or call me and let me know. Our thought today is don't worry. Worrying doesn't help. Our worries haven't prevented one disaster along the way. At times, the only thing we've prevented is our joy. Our worries are fear. We say, I will worry and be fearful until things have worked out. Only then can I relax and enjoy. Our worries are self-punishment, a form of not forgiving ourselves, not loving ourselves, and not trusting. We may think that worrying helps ward off trouble, but that's an illusion. Sometimes worrying brings troubles upon us because we're so caught up in our fear that we don't take the responsible steps that we need to take. By neglecting our lives due to worry and fear, we may bring needless consequences upon ourselves. The lesson is trust. When we are trusting, we let go of our fear, confident that what we want and need will come. We trust that if what comes appears to be trouble or hardship, we will get what we need to get through that also. When we trust, we get peaceful first before we get what we want, before we see what the future brings. And I thought that idea about worrying was a really good message today, given the situation of our world right now with our COVID-19 virus floating around everywhere. But this not only applies to, this lesson not only applies to worrying about the world situation right now and the virus, but also about our everyday lives. You've heard me many times in class talk about this particular idea about worrying and how it really doesn't benefit us in any way. So what I always try to live by with myself, and when it comes to worrying, is to ask myself, the number one question is, can I do anything about this? Can I change it? If the answer is no, I really can't, then I need to let go. And one of my favorite sayings is let go and let God. And in this case with the coronavirus, probably a really good thing to do if you are worrying about it. And the other question that I say is, well, if the answer is yes, I can do something about it, then I need to get busy and actually do something about it. So when you think about all the things you worry about, ask those questions. Is there anything I can do right now? If there isn't, then you just have to trust and have faith. If there is something you can do, then by all means, do everything you can. So keep that in mind as you go through these challenging times right now. And then even when this crisis is over, continue with this idea of not letting worry always dampen your joy in living. So let's go ahead and begin today, as we always do, with the breath. Today we're going to work on the breath in a equal breath. So we're going to inhale to a count and exhale, and we're going to keep that equal. And I'll help count it out for a few breaths, and then you can just count silently to yourself. If you're at home, I guess you could just count out loud, but it would be hard for you to breathe and count at the same time. So it's always best to just kind of get the rhythm of it. And so that's why I'll kind of help you out here. So relax and drop the shoulders down. Sit nice and tall. Just bring your ears over the top of your shoulders and sit up nice and straight through the spine with the abdominal muscles contracted ever so slightly, just to help maintain your alignment and your posture. Before we start the count, let's just close our eyes and just take a moment and tune into your breath, just noticing your inhale and your exhale. feel the breath as it moves from the bottom of the lungs to the top of the lungs. When you exhale, that breath leaves lungs completely, drawing the navel back toward the spine. So let's begin on our next inhale to a count of four. We'll inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale 4, 3, 2, 1. Now just keep that rhythm flowing. And yes, if you want to count silently to yourself as you are flowing through your inhales and exhales, go ahead. But just awareness of that calm, equal breath. Sometimes we take the breath in nice and deep and slow, but we tend to exhale rather quickly. And we don't want to miss any of the breath work. The inhale and the exhale, equally important. And then just let your breath fall into its natural rhythm here as you drop your head to the left and release, stretching through the side of the neck. Back to center. Exhaling, dropping your head to the right. Trying to keep your shoulders level here so that when you're dropping your head toward your shoulder, you're not leaning your whole body over, but just keeping the shoulders level, which will help increase that stretch in the side of the neck. And back to center. Tucking chin in toward the chest. And then drop your left ear over the left shoulder again. Then turn your face down toward the mat. Draw the chin to center and turn your face out. And then face down to the mat, chin to center and face out. A slow, gentle release of any tightness in the neck. Maybe hearing a little noise as you do this one. And remember, noises in our joints is quite all right as long as there's no pain. And then the next time your head comes back to center, tuck the chin in a little deeper in toward the chest, sit up a little taller. And then go ahead and gently bring your head back to center. Interlace the fingers, press the palms out, stretch through the upper back, and bring the arms up overhead. And then let's take our gaze upward a little bit. Breathing through. Exhale, take the arms down, palms to the mat. And then press into the right hand as you bring the left arm up. And then just stretch over and drop the head to the right. Extend and reach. Inhale up and drop the left hand to the mat. Inhale the right arm up. Extend and reach. And draw over toward your left as you drop your head toward the mat. Reach and stretch. Inhale back up, exhale down. Take the hands behind you, interlace your fingers, and just press your hands down toward the mat as you draw your shoulders back. Maybe take your gaze up if you choose, or you can look straight ahead. And release. And go ahead, straight the legs out front. Point the toes downward, and then draw the toes back. And then just point and flex. And release. Gently roll to the side, coming to your all fours for your cat-cow today. And as always, line your wrists underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, and begin your flow through cat-cow. We'll start by sinking the navel down toward the mat. Elbows stay nice and straight. Tailbone lifts up toward the ceiling. And we'll lift head and neck. And then we'll exhale a breath and round into cat. And then just continue to flow through your cat-cow. Remember that we are inhaling the breath, and we come into our cow, and exhaling the breath into our cat. Just warm through the spine, feel each and every vertebrae moving. And letting that next one be the last one. From there, sitting back into your child's pose, knees together or separated, wherever you're comfortable. And then stacking hands if you like, resting forehead on stacked hands. Relax your shoulders down, really release in child's pose. Feel the breath as you take a nice deep breath in. Rib cage pressing against the side of the thighs, or if you have your thighs or knees right underneath you, belly pressing into the top of the thighs and releasing. Just feel the movement of the breath. From there, extend the arms out, spread the fingers wide onto the knees, curling the toes and pressing up into your downward facing dog. Feet are hip width apart here, fingers spread nice and wide and pointing straight forward. As we drop the heels downward toward the mat, raise the tail upward. And today, let's pedal through our downward dog a little bit. Keep the arms strong. Maybe turn the inside of the elbows inward just a little bit as we bend one knee and press the opposite heel downward, and then alternating, keeping the tailbone nice and high as you pedal through. Called pedaling, or sometimes I like the idea that I've seen people call this walk the dog, so I like that idea too. And then go ahead and press both heels down, tailbone rising, shoulders always released away from the ears. And today we're going to walk our feet up toward our hands. So just begin to walk the feet upward. If the hands are comfortable touching the mat here with knees straight, go ahead, or you can bend your knees here, wherever you're comfortable with this. And then we're just going to drop down, grasp the elbows, and drop the crown of the head toward the mat. Now, again, knees can be bent deeply here. That's totally fine. We're Release the arms and bend your knees really deep as you inhale, coming all the way up. Exhale and release down. Take your feet a comfortable distance apart. And today we'll work on alternating our sunflower and moonflower. So we'll take an inhale overhead and we'll just exhale, bend the knees, come down and just sweep for your sunflower. Inhale back up. And this time when we exhale, bring the elbows in toward the waist and just come down, bend the knees, back up. Exhale down, sunflower. Inhale up. Exhale, moonflower. And just flow through a couple of these at your own pace. You can go a little quicker, a little slower, whatever works for you. And running, next one, B, the last one. Arms down, feet together, and back toward the front of your mat. Let's just take a nice deep stretch overhead. We'll lock the thumbs and lift and lengthen through the body. And a slight little back bend here, just coming back. And releasing down. Take your feet hip width apart. We'll do a nice little easy twist here with the arms out to the side. Shoulders relaxed and down. And we're going to just gently twist. Looking over toward your hand. And back to center. And it doesn't matter which way you twist it. Move to the other side. And back to center. Release the arms. Inhale overhead. Palms together and exhaling to the heart center. Close your eyes if you like, or looking down toward your heart. Take just a moment. Checking in with your body. Observing, noticing any areas today you are healing, any areas today that are just needing a little extra care. Always listen to your body, pay attention, and treat your body well. Perhaps asking what you need from your practice today. Again, a nice question is just to simply say, what do I need? And that answer may be your intention. Or perhaps you have a whole different intention for your practice today or for your day ahead. But if you choose, go ahead and set that intention now. And releasing when you are ready. I'm going to start right out with a lunge today. So take your left foot back. And just sink into a comfortable lunge. So we don't want to go to our maximum right now. We're just going to sink into a comfortable lunge. We're going to relax the shoulders down. We're just going to keep the hands on the hips here and just stretch nice and deep through the hip flexor and the quad. Getting a little feel for your balance here maybe today. And just letting that stretch. Push the left heel back toward the wall. And then we're just going to turn this right into our warrior one. If you are comfortable lowering your heel to the mat, go ahead. If not, step it up a little bit until you can anchor your left foot to the mat. Feel that stretch in your calf, maybe even an Achilles heel there. And then inhale the arms overhead. Release the shoulders down. Work on drawing your arms upward. And of course, always take your option of arms down, goalpost arms if you need to, if shoulders need that comfort. Work on engaging the abs a little bit in your warrior one. Work on keeping the toes uncurled on the mat. And exhale down. Step the left foot up and the right foot back. Step back to a comfortable lunge here. Find your balance, anchor through your left foot, raising the right heel from the mat, sinking the hips down a little bit, working on shoulders right over hips here in your lunge. And hands to hips, or if you want to take them out to the side if you need that. But just focusing on that stretch right here in the hip flexor and the quad. Breath flowing. We want the stretch to be feeling good right now. Just a good, gentle stretch. And then lowering that right heel down, but again, too much stretch. Step the right foot up a little bit to come into a comfortable warrior one position. Inhale the arms overhead. Reach and stretch. Shoulders relaxed. Abs engaged. Curls, our toes uncurled. Sometimes we start to grip those toes right into the mat. So uncurl the toes. And release. Go ahead and pivot around sideways on your mat. Take your feet a comfortable distance apart here. And if you have blocks today, you can bring those in if you like. If not, just work where you can with it. We're going to come down into a half fold here from our wide stance. So hinge up the hips, fold forward, slide the palms down to the shins maybe, or maybe to the top of the thighs as far as you're comfortable going. And then work on bringing fingertips or palms to the mat, fist for wrist, or using your blocks if you need to. Work on placing your wrist right underneath your shoulders. So rather than have your hands too far out, we're going to start with them right under the shoulders here. You can walk your feet out for a nice wide stretch here in the inner thighs. And then dropping the crown of the head downward. If you have any issues with dizziness, any reason you should not have head below the heart, then of course you're going to keep your head above your heart. Otherwise, just release the shoulders down, crown of the head down toward the mat. Looking for that nice stretch through the inner thighs here. So you're just going to drop as low as you are comfortable going. Notice the soles of the feet stay anchored on the mat. So we don't want to roll the feet in or roll the feet out. We want good stability and support throughout the whole foot. And remember, you can drop as deep as you like. Forearms could come to the mat. Crown of the head could come to the mat if you like. And then go ahead and raise your head above your heart and walk your hands over toward your right foot. Now, if you are not able to do that on the mat or you don't have your blocks, you're just going to kind of take the one hand over so that you have both hands on the top of the thigh or the shins. And that's okay to be right there or up here. But if you're able to take that reach, and then slide or walk your hands back to center and move over toward the other side. And again, if you need to have hands on the thigh or both hands on the shin, you can do that. Walking hands back to center. Draw the feet inward, just kind of heel toe. Come in pretty close, not a little farther than shoulder width. And then bend the knees and sit back into your squat. If you like, bring your arms up, push back into a nice deep squat here. Pull the abs in nice and tight. And then inhale and come up. And exhale down. We'll go through a little series here with warrior two. So the left foot is facing toward the long side of the mat. The right foot is facing the short side. And remember that lunge we were working on before we did our warrior one. So we're going to take that stance nice and wide and bend the right knee. We've had that nice stretch in the inner thighs here. So we can take our warrior two nice and wide. Look for your, alignment, heel to arch on the mat. And then inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, shoulder level. Shoulders relax and we look out over the top of the right hand. Right knee should be facing straight forward. Release the arms down, moving into side angle today. Adding a little level of challenge to side angle if you choose today. So let's go ahead and begin with the right forearm on top of the right thigh. And keep your left shoulder back so you don't roll forward with this. And then if you have shoulder problems, keep your left arm behind your back the whole time. If you are comfortable with the left shoulder, you can inhale the arm up. And then continue to reach and stretch. Palm begins to face downward toward the mat. And we just extend and reach. The challenge today for side angle is to lift our right forearm from the top of the thigh. Now get your abs engaged nice and tight here. And then just sweep that right arm out, palms facing one another. Breathe through and reach. It's hard. And come back up. Ooh, and drop the arms down. So continuing on, and always know if you need to take your break here in your mountain pose, you can bring the feet together and take a break here. We're just going to go ahead and keep this nice wide stance and work on our triangle today. Inhale the arms overhead. Exhale, shoulder level. Imagine that you are standing against the wall. So the tips of the shoulder blades are just touching that wall. And you can only move left to right. You don't have any forward movement here. So we're going to reach the right arm. We're just going to reach nice and far. Feel that inner thigh. Adductor muscle on the right side. Stretching. Right arm slowly comes down. Left arm comes up or behind your back. You may look out, down, or up in triangle, but keep drawing that left shoulder blade back, imagining that wall behind you. So in your triangle, you should feel a nice stretch going right here through that left side of the back. Don't forget to breathe. And release, coming up slow and easy. And again, stepping into mountain pose if you need it, or pivoting right around to the other side. And it's always nice to take that rest if you need it. If your body's starting to tire or sometimes triangle, really get your heart rate up, and you also can get that sense of like, oh, I need to catch my breath. So you may want to step into mountain pose for that, and then you just join back in when you're ready. So into warrior two on the other side, shoulders square forward, left knee bends, inhale the arms overhead, and exhale, shoulder level, turn and gaze out past your left hand, and keep the abs pulled in, keep the left knee pointed straight forward, and make sure your left knee is not extended beyond your big toes. Big toe on this side. We only have one big toe. Breathing. Now for that challenge of side angle. Left forearm down. And remember, you can draw your right shoulder back. Take your hand behind your back and work right here. Or if you choose, you can slowly bring your right arm up and then continue to reach over. Right palm is facing toward the floor. Now remember the shoulders, this one is a lot like triangle. We don't want to reach and start to drop the right shoulder forward. We still stay right back here. If you're up for the challenge, sweep the left arm up. Palm facing upward. Breathe. If you're like me, you might find it a little harder on one side than the other. And release, coming back up and squaring the shoulders forward. Readjust on your feet if you need to. Get that nice line. If you have draw an imaginary line on your mat, with left heel and right arch on that line. Triangle, inhale up. Exhale, shoulder level. Abs engaged as you reach. Remember, your shoulder blades are just sliding along that imaginary wall behind you. Left arm down, right arm up or behind your back. Choosing where you are most comfortable looking, down, out, or up. Release, coming up, turn the left foot in and step the feet together, relax the shoulders, shake out the knees a little bit as you take a breath in your mountain pose. Nice deep breath, notice how your body's feeling and just breathe through it. And then spending a little time with pyramid today. I'm going to bring my blocks in case you have blocks at home and you want to follow along. And again, if you don't have blocks, our bodies always make for nice props, and we can use shins and thighs to do that. So let's take the left foot back and the right foot forward. Now, I'm going to turn sideways for this one because I want you to pay attention to our fold and a little bit with the movement of the hips. So we're going to step the left foot back, and we're going to let the left foot turn out. And you can take a nice wide stance here, or you can shorten it up. And then we're going to square the shoulders and the hips straight forward. And that's going to be only according to your left foot. If your left foot is turned out a lot, your hips are going to turn a little bit. But we'll get that left foot straightened in a little bit here. Do the best you can. And we're going to hinge and move forward right from the hips. So just bend right at the hip joint and come down. So you can always start with hands on the top of the thigh or the shin. Or if you have your blocks today, you can have hands on blocks at any level. Once you are a little more secure here, and if you don't need blocks, fingertips or hands can go right to the mat. If you're here or here, shin or thighs, you're probably going to go ahead and keep that left foot turned out a little bit just for a little more stability. If you have stability with hands touching floor or mat or blocks, we're going to pivot the left foot and bring the left foot forward facing. You might have to bend and step the foot up a little bit so that we can anchor. Now notice the front of your left hip. Think about the left hip bone as a light, a little beam of light. Draw that beam of light right down toward the mat. We're kind of leveling out here through the back. And it would be possible to do this with hands on thighs or shins, but only if you have your left foot forward facing. So level the hips, sink down into your pyramid. Go ahead, pull the abs in nice and tight as you come up, slow and easy. Release. Step the left foot up and the right foot back. And you can always try, even if you don't have your blocks here, you can always try to start with the feet on the parallel tracks and just take a moment and get your balance here. Stack the shoulders right over the hips. And if that's just not possible today for your balance, let your foot turn out. And then we're going to hinge at the hips. We're going to come forward. Nice and slow and easy. Just drop and down. Relax the shoulders. Let the shoulders, the crown of the head, drop down toward the mat. Again, maybe hands are on shins. Maybe you're up a little bit higher here in your pyramid pose. So wherever your body can go today. Remember, we're working on stretching the back of the left hamstring. So we don't want to bend that left knee to accommodate the stretch. We want to keep the left knee straight but not locked. And if we need to come up a little bit, go ahead and do that rather than bend the left knee. Abs engaged as you inhale, coming up slow and easy. Pivot around, step to the front of the mat, and take a breath in mountain pose. Good job with that one. We've been holding them today. It was a little bit harder than the previous videos have been, but that's the idea. We'll just kind of increase our level of intensity and then always back down too, and you can always go back to one of the easier videos if you need to. Going into balance today. Today, I think we're going to start with balancing pigeon. So we'll start with the feet hip width apart. Always remember to find that focal point. Sometimes in your house, it's pretty distracting, lots of things to look at. So pick out one small thing that you can kind of keep your gaze on, and that will help you with your balance. Starting on either foot you like, I'm going to shift my weight to my right foot and then make a figure four, bringing your left foot just above your right knee. Finding your balance right here. And this might be as far as your balance goes with this today, and that is totally fine. If your balance is completely off, you might have to go down here and let the big toe kind of touch on the floor. If you are comfortable, bring the palms to the heart center and taking the elbows out, and then bending the right knee, sitting back into a chair pose, and just down. Breathing through. And find the place where you are steady. Not important to go as deep as possible, but more important to be steady. And release. Good job. Other side. And do take into account that a lot of you may be working on your mat, on carpet. Balance is going to be much harder in that situation. If you have the opportunity to step to a hard floor, tile or wood, that will make your balance easier. But on the other hand, if you're working on carpet, you're just going to be that much better at it when you get back to the studio on the hardwood. Other side, bring, take the time to find your focal point. Bending the left knee a little bit, coming down. And it's okay to start over. And release. Good job with that. We'll have some harder balances coming up on our next video, but we'll just stick with that one for now. I'm trying to keep these videos to about an hour just because it takes so long to get them uploaded. So we're not getting quite as much in these classes as we do at the studio when I do an hour and 15, but I don't want to short you on your relaxation. So go ahead and take a nice inhale overhead. Exhale and just swan that forward. Slow and gentle, bend the knees. Step back into your downward facing dog. And then release into your child's pose. Take a nice rest here. We've worked a little bit hard on our standing poses. Arms can be extended out or hands stacked under you, wherever you're comfortable. And once again, as you feel the breath move in and out, rib cage pressing against the top of the thighs or expanding, feeling that rib cage on the inner thighs, depending on how you have your knees positioned. And just appreciate the breath. From there, draw the palms back up the mat and let's gently roll to the side. Extend the legs out and stretch things out here. We'll work on spinal twists today. And I think let's just do just a nice basic one today and know that later in the week we'll get prepared to do our cow face spinal twist. So the most important thing we want to do is kind of walk each hip back. Just kind of side to side, and then you can kind of feel yourself if you're rock side to side, you're anchored right on the sit bones. And then we'll bend the left knee, and we're going to cross the left foot over the right knee, and we're going to pull that left foot in nice and close toward us. Now, it's quite all right to have that foot out farther, and it's also okay to twist without crossing over. Want the right foot flexed. And we're sitting up nice and tall. We're going to draw in the breath. And we're going to move from the lower part of the rib cage, the abs around, left hand behind you, and draw your left shoulder back. And bring that left hand in nice and close to your body so that you are not leaning and lunging into your twist. If you want to engage the abs a little bit more, instead of hugging and holding that knee in, just rest your elbow on top of the knee and get the abs engaged. Don't forget to breathe while you're holding your twist. Draw in a deep breath. Begin coming around with the head, neck, shoulders, chest, abs, and release. Other side. Find your comfortable position here with the left leg extended. Drawing your right knee in nice and close to your body. And again, we're going to take a nice deep breath in. We're going to twist from that lower to the chest, neck, and head last. Come around. Breathe nice and deep here. If you want to hold the knee in toward your body, or if you want a little more work with the core, elbow sits on top of the knee. And come around, head, shoulders, chest, abs. And release. Go ahead and roll onto your belly on your mat. And work on locust pose today. So we'll roll the hips side to side a little bit, and we'll drop the tops of the feet to the mat. And then we're going to just come down, and you can rest your forehead on the mat if you like, or if you want to keep your nose just a little ways from the mat. It's really up to you. Arms are going to come down along the side of the body with the palms facing in. And then lift the hands up just a little bit. And from here, as you look down toward your mat, you're going to draw the crown of the head forward. With the abs engaged tightly, we're just going to draw the shoulder blades down and then lift the legs upward and breathe. Release down and turn your head to one side. Palms facing up, feet roll out, and just relax right here, just for a breath or two. And then we'll come back into locust pose once again, but this time we're going to interlace the fingers behind the back. Forehead resting on the mat, if that's your preference, or forehead just slightly above the mat. Draw the shoulders down. Lift the arms up. Abs engaged and lift the feet. Breathe as you're lifting. And release. Go ahead and sweep the wrist up, and today, if you want a little more challenge with your up dog, bring your wrist a little closer down toward your waist. If you need less, you bring your wrist up a little bit higher. I'm going to go down to waist today, see where I'm at. And of course, the elbows tuck in really close to the body. Take in a breath, push up. Release the glutes. Look up, and then release back into an extended child's pose. To your all fours here today, and step your left foot between your hands, and then walk the right foot back, coming into another lunge here today. And you may keep your right knee on the mat and the top of the foot on the mat if you like, or toe can be curled, and we're just going to stretch that lunge back nice and deep. And now drop the right knee down to the mat. Walk your hands back. And you can have your blocks here on either side of you if you like. And rather than lean way over to the right with your hip, we're going to try to keep the hips in line as much as possible. And we're just going to sit back nice and deep without actually dropping the hips down. I know you're thinking we're going to do splits today, but we're not doing that today. But it will be coming. And release back up. And bring your right foot up. Extend that left leg back as far as you can. And again, the left knee can stay on the mat if you like, or you can curl the toes and stretch it back right here, wherever you're comfortable. Breathe through. We're getting a lot of good stretching today in the hip flexors and the quads. Dropping the left knee down, walking the hands back as you straighten through the right knee, the right toes can lift off the mat. And I'm going to keep those hips nice and straight. Sit back as far as you can go without actually collapsing or releasing onto the mat. Stretching nice and deep here. And release. Coming back to your all fours. Wrists underneath the shoulders. And then bend the right knee, flex the foot, and just lift sole of the foot up toward the ceiling. And draw the front of the right hip downward. Now pressing through your right hand, take your left hand, reach around for your right ankle. A little quad stretch there. And release, and we'll switch that to the other side. So you're just in a basic tabletop all fours position. Flex the left foot, bend the left knee, lift up. Press through the right hand, and look balance here. Press through the left hand, wrong side. Reach back for your right ankle. And stretch. Good job. And release. Child's pose. And finishing up today with bridge pose. So come around onto your mat, lie back, and take a hug of the knees into your chest. Soles of the feet down onto the mat. And not just any bridge pose, but one leg bridge pose. So You can certainly do keep both feet on the mat if you like. This is entirely up to you. We'll start with, let's all go into a regular bridge pose. Arms down alongside the body, abs pulled in, and just roll up through the spine. And this is where you will stay if you choose to remain in our standard bridge pose. Those who would like to work with that core a little bit today, we're going to pull the abs in nice and tight here. And then we're going to see if we can keep these hips right where they are. And then just extend the left leg up toward the ceiling. Now, if your hips drop down, try to keep them back up. Breathing through. Strong core. And then lower that leg. Breathe. Keep the hips up. And then take the left foot back down to the mat. Roll down through the spine. And take a breath. Other side. Rolling up slow and easy into your bridge. Lifting your bridge to your level of comfort or challenge, if you like. Breathe in your bridge pose. Those who are taking on the challenge of a little extra core work here. Extend the right leg up toward the ceiling point. Pull the core in. Lower down if you're comfortable. Keep the hips raised. And then bend the knee, coming back down nice and easy. Hugging the knees into the chest, and we are ready for relaxation. So gather whatever you need to get comfortable today, and remember to use your blankets, your eye mask, whatever you have, your padding, bolsters, whatever you have that helps you settle in to your relaxation. First thing you want to do is take a moment and tune in to your breath. After that work on bridge, your heart rate may be up a little bit, maybe the breath. So just take a moment and just let the breath and the heart rate begin to calm and lower. Gently begin to squeeze through the legs, squeezing the calves, squeezing the thighs, and release. Lengthen through the arms, spread the fingers wide, folding fingers inward, squeezing gently through the forearms, through the upper arms. Now squeeze through the glutes, drawing the muscles in tighter and tighter. And slowly relaxing those muscles as if they're just melting into the earth. Draw the shoulders upward toward your ears. Release and draw the shoulders down toward your feet. Release. Bring your shoulders forward as if to touch in front of your body. Release and draw the shoulders back, shoulder blades moving closer to the spine. A gentle turn of your head side to side. Relaxing muscles of the neck. Bringing your head back to center. And opening the mouth, gently moving your jaw up and down, side to side. Now bringing your lips together, squeeze gently as you pull the cheeks inward, followed by puffing the cheeks outward. Release. Crinkle your nose. Release. And flare the nostrils wide. Release. Close your eyes a little tighter with a gentle squeeze. Release and raise the eyebrows to wrinkle the forehead. Release. Now imagine you're drawing all your facial muscles together as if they're all meeting at a point at the tip of your nose. Release. Scan through your body, check in, noticing any areas today of tightness, any areas you have awareness that you are holding on to some stress in your life today. Check in and see what you might do by using the breath, movement, combining the two, and release, surrender a little bit more. From there, make any adjustments you may need, changing the position that you're in. Sometimes we just need to tweak it a little bit. Sometimes we need to change it all together. Just finding where your body can truly rest and settle in. Notice the thoughts in your mind today. And begin to quiet down some of the busyness in the mind. Release any negativity. Let go of any concerns or worries. Set all of that aside and create a space for you. In that space, bring forth whatever it might be that comes to your mind that is peaceful. Something as simple as one word sometimes, a color, a prayer, a place, real or imaginary. Just whatever it is that automatically just sends you to a place of peace. Begin to feel the energy, this beautiful energy of this peace all around you, flowing through the feet, ankles, shins, calves, knees and thighs, relaxed. Peaceful energy flows through the fingers, palms of the hands, backs of the hands, forearms, upper arms, relaxed. Feel this peace begin to flow through the hips, the abdomen, through all the internal organs, flowing upward through the rib cage, relaxing the lungs, relaxing the heart, peace, love, joy flowing through your heart. From there, the energy continues to flow upward, across the top of the shoulders, around and down the sides of the rib cage, and around to the base of the spine. Once again, imagine your energy as a warm, healing energy flowing upward, weaving in and out, around and through each and every vertebrae, finding its way all the way up to the very last vertebrae of the neck. From there, the peace flows along through the jawline, relaxing the mouth, cheeks, nose, eyes, forehead. Continue on in this peaceful state of mind, in this relaxed body, making that connection between mind, body, and spirit. Relax, enjoy. Please begin to become aware of the breath, beginning to deepen the breath, wiggling fingers and toes, gently rolling arms and legs, bending the knees, placing the soles of the feet on the mat, taking a relaxing stretch overhead if you like. From there, gently rolling onto your right side, or choosing any position that you find comfortable. Take just a moment as you just soak in your peace today. And while you do that, remember, worry and fear are the opposite of love. Love yourself more than you ever have. Love yourself enough to stop worrying. Love yourself enough to give yourself the gift of peace. Take your time as you gently press through the palm of your hand, bringing your body upward, slowly, gently, finding your way back to a comfortable sitting position. Draw in a deep breath. Exhale the breath and feel a sense of having been renewed, restored through your practice today. And may we all truly understand that to be concerned, as we all are, about our family, friends, neighbors, and the world, that's a good thing. But to worry is just a waste of our energy. When we are concerned, we can pray, we can be of service. There are so many things we can do to be helpful. But when we worry, we tend to just destroy our peace, our sanity, and sometimes the peace of those around us. So let go of your worry today and truly trust that you are strong enough to get through anything that comes your way. The love, the light, and the goodness within me recognizes and truly appreciates the love, the light, the goodness within each and every one of you. Namaste. And once again, I thank all of you for joining me in our at-home yoga. And again, keep those vibes coming through. I am really enjoying doing this. I don't mind at all, but really ready to get back to the studio and get back in touch again. So in the meantime, as I said, if you've got some suggestions or you have anything you're really needing from your yoga practice, don't hesitate to get in touch with me. And we'll certainly do what we can to make sure that your yoga needs are being met at Nspired Yoga. So stay well, stay safe, and miss you all. Bye-bye now.